Check out the writer's strike, then realise your own writers have gone on strike and you have to write the opening bit yourself, and that's why it's gone on so long and it isn't very funny. It's Friday, we're live, and it's time for the last leg. Tonight on the show, we'll check out the hottest stories of the week. Big up Joe Biden in the UK and ask whether AI could take over Hollywood. Plus, we'll be joined by comedians Rosie Jones and Babatunde Eleshe and actor Brian Cox. On the show that always immerses itself in the news. G'day, hello, I'm Adam Hills. Welcome to The Last Leg, the show that heard MPs were talking about Swifties in Parliament this week and assumed it was another sex scandal. With me, as always, are the Pride of Dartmoor, Josh Widdicombe, and the man who saw Blur live in concert last weekend, but only because he misread the poster and thought he was seeing Blue, Alex Brooker! Now, before... Away! Woo-hoo! This is not part of the show. This is not part of the show. Do you know what? Hey.
I'm William.
Hi, William.
You did a bigger version of William last week.
Do you know what?
We tell you about my grandchildren.
My God. I absolutely hate myself.
Here's Ivy, 3 years old. She's just beginning.
Oh, I'm not allowed. Okay.
Wow.
Wow. So, yeah, good work.
My hero. Come on. Do you know what? Alex, save me!
And I will always love you.
I'm not going to lie to you, I shat myself. When I saw it was just stop oil, I was very relieved because we slagged off Putin last week. Oh, my God.
Do you know what? I'm going to say it.
You know what? I thought there was three people that weren't laughing.
I'm going to say it. We said on the show last week, if that's what every Just Stop Oil protest is like, I'm down with it.
Yeah.
If it's people coming out smiling and throwing orange confetti, absolutely bring it on. I mean, know when to get the fuck off. But do you know what? That's great. We should schedule. Can we do that every show?
Feel my heart rate. I'm not sleeping tonight.
Honestly,
I regret not bringing my inhaler.
Honestly, it's like he's back in Glastonbury.
Oh my God, that was like.
Do you know what? If ever, you know, you play that game. What? How would you cope in an Armageddon? Like in a nuclear future? Like, if Josh is freaked out by an old man in orange throwing confetti.
It was in my peripheral vision.
No, it's a good point.
I thought it might be an assassin.
It's not often you get a protester who introduces themselves either.
Yeah, that was really odd. That was real then.
That wasn't part of the show. I genuinely wasn't part of the show.
Surprise me and Josh.
You've got to
say,
yeah,
they've got to start searching those bags for orange confetti.
Probably no in this show. It's probably hidden in a leg or something. So don't.
We should get on with the show.
Here's what I'll say, yeah.
Do you know what I'm most offended about?
Yeah.
That they had a free ticket to watch the whole show.
Yeah.
They knew they'd be thrown out and they didn't want to watch any of it. Decided to go before they'd even checked whether the first joke was good.
Also, by the way, I mean, fair play. It's kind of a ballsy thing to try that on a live TV show.
Yeah, don't do it again, though. I'm shitting myself.
Yeah, don't invite
me. Well, I tell you what, let's see how committed they are to the cause if they want to jump on with Orange High Viz on a Northern Irish TV show. All right, we do have a show, and that's all we have time for. So thanks for watching. just stop comedy. Okay, we've got loads.
My God.
Of all the weeks, we've got so much to cover this week as well. Okay, firstly...
What I love is what, what we're about to move on to.
Do we cover this? Well, let's... You
no, no, no. Yeah, here's a connection. Yeah, Just Stop Oil's important because of global warming, which leads to sunspots. Now, I want to address a few tweets I've received lately about a mole on my neck. How's that for a wink? Honestly,
what a gear shift.
We've had
Are
a whole bunch...
Are we on the one show? No, because they have got adequate security.
I didn't realise the security had one leg too.
But you know what? You even said before the show, you noticed there was a security guard up here.
Yeah,
which we don't
and I
normally
was just
have.
Like, oh, this geezer's here, ready to go if there's any Just Stop Oil people.
He's on the wrong side.
Yeah, no, he's having a pint.
All right.
Imagine if they're out
it's
the back.
It's because the security
the
were the security were all stood at the side.
It's like a Weatherspoons. That's what they wouldn't have done that. Fucking... Tiger Tiger in Leeds had been getting the fucking shit. Too nice this show.
No, but the two security blokes were stood at the side, looked at them, they went, "Is this one of their shit sketches?" It's time to bring on tonight's guests.
What are we dropping? I'm asking the producer. Do we just move on?
Nah, let's talk about it.
Okay, we'll drop stuff later. You're exactly right. Okay, so I did get a whole bunch of tweets, and I've been getting them for the past couple of series, like this one from Anne, who said, "Is it okay to be worried about the mole on Adam's neck or chin? Don't remember it being there before. Hope you've had a look at it." And then Nick Jackson also said, "Is it okay that I've never noticed the mole on Adam's neck? Please look into it." So it's this one here.
I just think something's growing back. It's a positive.
I
like
to know if it's a leg, is that good or is that problematic? So I've got two legs, but one of them is here.
But wouldn't it be so sad? Is that the one on your...
There, yeah, there. I don't know. I'm assuming that's the one they're referring to.
I don't think you should worry about it. I've got a phrase that is good to think about here.
Mm.
I don't think you should make a mountain out of a mole, Hills.
Oh, really nice.
Yeah. For those
that I tell you who's kicking themselves right now, Just Stop Oil missed out on that.
I have had it checked. It's something called it's called a senile wart. Apparently, it's from the sun, and Australians tend to get them more than other nationalities.
Yeah,
because of the sun. But we tend to get them on the right-hand side of our bodies.
Is that, like, to do with, you know, like the toilet when it flushes? It kind of goes anti-clockwise. Can you, like, only turn one...
No, it's because that's... We drive on that side and the sun comes in on that side, so we get all the sunspots
you have
on that
your
side.
Your arm out.
Are you worried at all that the mole's going to try and get rid of you? It's just going to be saying to the other moles, do you reckon this bloke's changed size recently?
I did get one cut off. There was one down here that I got cut off because it was borderline. But I've got it here in a little box. There you go. That's my little mole. A little... Oh. And have a listen.
Oh, g'day!
Alex, you also got a weird tweet recently.
Yeah, so I got a tweet this week telling me that I should... well, it's just saying that somebody thinks that I should be in films.
Ooh.
So I kind of got, like, that excited. You think, you know, they probably looked at me and gone, like Magic Mike or Magic Mike 2. But, no, what it said was, "At Alex Brooker, have you ever thought about a guest spot in Star Wars or Star Trek as an alien?" It would be really nice. I said it would be good for disabled people to get more representation. So, I mean, you look at it one way, or, yeah, you know, you could look, it's a positive. They want to see more of me out there. They think I could just get into films, or they just think, do you know what, you're quite weird looking. You're almost there anyway. So, yeah.
Yeah. Are you thinking of doing it? Of auditioning to be an alien?
I think I'd make a great E.T. I reckon I'd make a great E.T. just being like, "Elliot, mate, I've got to make a call home a second. Hang on a second." Yeah, no, yeah, no.
I know I said I was only going out for a couple of pints. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
What would you be called?
I don't know. I used to get called Han Solo at school. Luke Skywalker.
Yeah. Yeah, if you're Han Solo, I'm Luke Needs a Walker.
No, you're Darth Maul.
If you haven't already worked it out, we are live. You can tweet us about whatever you want to talk about tonight. There's been, look, one huge story dominating the news this week, and our attitude to it can be summed up by this tweet from Liz Henwood, who said, "Is it okay that all the media want to talk about is the BBC presenter when Boris Johnson has failed to hand over his phone to the COVID inquiry by the deadline and the world is breaking heat records? No, it's not." So, let's start with the story itself. Last weekend, the Sun newspaper ran an article about a BBC presenter who allegedly paid a young person for explicit photos. Some say the reporting was in the public interest, but others claim it was reckless, dangerous, and borderline libelous. Now, while the Sun didn't actually say anything criminal had gone on, they did use words like youngster and teenager, and were also criticised for not mentioning that the lawyer for the person involved said it was rubbish. All this from a publication that used to print explicit photos of teenage girls on page 3. And look, we do need to hold truth to power, and there is definitely a story here. But is it a 15-minute segment at the top of the national news, and every national news, when, as Liz pointed out, the planet is literally on fire?
Well, the thing that I found intriguing about the coverage this week, I don't know if you saw it,
yeah,
was the BBC News Department reporting on the BBC News Department. Aren't they all just in the same office? And just being like, "Hey, John, you got anything to say on this?" Nah. BBC News Department had no comment. Like, if, yeah, because Victoria Derbyshire had to interview Tim Davies. She was basically interviewing her boss.
Yeah.
If we had the head of Channel 4 on this show,
yeah,
she went for him.
Yeah.
We had the channel head of Channel 4 on this show, my first question would be, why are you so good-looking? And look, my second question would be, how do we beef up security?
Look, a lot of you tweeted us about this story. Our opinion is we don't need to add more fuel to the fire, especially while all the facts are still being collected. So let's all take a deep breath, a step back, and focus on what's important. Because you tell me what's bigger news. BBC anchor allegedly pays for sexy pics, or former Prime Minister defies a court order to hand over evidence into an inquiry about how he handled the biggest health crisis in a generation. Because, yes, Boris Johnson missed the deadline for handing in his phone to the COVID inquiry this week, claiming it's an old phone and he can't remember the password.
Bullshit.
I've got to ask, has anyone tried 6969? As a passcode, as a passcode, as a passcode.
That's the mole talking.
Or 58008, upside down. I don't know.
I reckon he messed up. He had one of the kids' birthdays, didn't he? He's like, fuck, I've forgotten.
But the thing is, I think with Boris is, if you think about the stuff that he openly said in public,
yeah,
like, what is on his phone? Like, you don't want to be opening that phone. I can imagine it'll be like Indiana Jones when they open the Ark. Just people's faces melting.
I'm glad he's not still in charge of the nuclear codes. Russia attack, he goes, I just can't remember, I'm sorry. I've been locked out for 15 minutes, I've had 3 tries, it's over.
Well, the interesting thing is he didn't actually say he'd forgotten. What he said was he couldn't be 100% confident of the number and was also worried that the phone might delete data after numerous failed attempts.
Yeah, big worry.
So our poll for tonight is, what other excuses will Boris Johnson give for not handing over his phone?
Rebecca Vardy's agent dropped it off a boat.
Lost it under a pile of his children?
Yeah. Maybe it's the name of one of his children, but you only get 10 attempts before the phone locks itself. Tweet us at The Last Leg or reply to us on Threads. Use the hashtag BorisBS.
Oh, they're still using that.
Boris and his wife, Carrie, welcomed a baby boy to the world this week, by the way, named Frank Alfred Odysseus Johnson. No prizes for guessing which name Boris chose. Odysseus
is a Greek character who leaves behind his wife and child to seek adventure and encounters numerous women?
Oh, so the kind of the insinuation is he kind of chose that name maybe because he likes what it means. Mm. I don't think there's anything in that. And I said that to my daughter Happy Hour the other day.
That is a lovely bit of business.
Lovely bit of business.
That is good humour we can all enjoy.
Fuck you, Justa Foyle.
No, do you know what? Well, I think we're having a better show because of them. I think we should have them every week.
And do you know what? They're the perfect studio warm-up. Sorry, Mark.
Imagine look, if I lost my blue badge because I tried to carry you out the show. Don't worry. Don't. DWP, it was just the adrenaline.
Look, the other big story that did get lost this week, as suggested by Liz, is that old chestnut, global warming. Last week was the world's hottest week on record, while this week a heat wave called Cerberus is due to sweep across Europe. That's right, there's a weather system named after the three-headed dog that guards the gates of hell.
And I'm not making this up. I read this right before the show. The next heat wave that's due next week is called Charon, which is the ferryman who delivers souls to the underworld.
So, while Keir Starmer reportedly said this week, I hate tree huggers, there was a nasty hailstorm...
So do I after tonight, mate.
A nasty hailstorm in Spain created what can only be called a hailberg.
Weird seeing the streets in Spain getting ruined and it's not by pissed up British people.
Six British blokes sat there. Six beers, por favor.
Do you want ice?
No, I'm good.
So in the week the planet lurched ever closer to climate change disaster, we were all talking about which presenter may have paid for sexy photos, mainly because the story about that presenter was sold to us so sensationally. So maybe the only way people will pay attention to the plight of the planet is either with a Just Stop Oil protest or if we frame the plight of the planet like a sordid scandal. Breaking news now, and an unnamed planet has been caught up in a hot, steamy scandal this week. The scandal began after sources revealed last Thursday was the world's hottest day ever, with a global average temperature that was a smoking 17.2 degrees. Since then, though, more days have come forward that were also barely 17. The seven hottest days on Earth all happened last week, and there are also claims of some scorching photos. Red-hot Mars has denied it's the planet in question. Perky Pluto says it's not even a planet. And to confuse things further, some incriminating images have been leaked online of Uranus. The planet's bosses have promised a thorough investigation, but there are reports the issue was raised with them as far back as the 1970s. We don't know all the facts, but as always with these stories, a lot of it has started with the sun. We'll have more for you as this story develops, but one thing's for sure, the planet is filthy. That's been your Salacious News. I'm an overpaid mouthpiece. All right, let's welcome tonight's guest. One snaps, one crackles, and one plays an emotionally distant pop. Please welcome Rosie Jones, Babatunde Eleshe, and Brian Cox. Welcome to you all. I mean...
Just stop!
All right, I'm going to go through some of the stories that we've had so far. Babatunde, what do you think about Boris and his mobile phone?
You know what? I'm laughing at the fact that he's trying to say that he forgot his password. It's just like, dude, we have face recognition now. You know what I'm saying? But also, if I was Boris, I wouldn't hand him my phone also because, like, imagine all the booty pics that he's got in his DMs. He can't show his, like, his wife that, you know what I'm saying? All these side chicks messaging him, you know what I'm saying? So yeah. I get it, man, I understand.
Rosie, what do you think about the name of his child?
I mean, it's a wonder that there are any names left.
And Brian, what do you think about the state of the planet?
Shite.
Save us some time. Made some time back up.
And yeah. We're back on time.
Ask me anything, you'll make time.
Possibly
all these people, by the way.
Oh, they're all part of the audience.
Oh, shit. I thought they were all going to be coming on.
Fuck for that.
One of the biggest news stories of the week was England men's and women's winning over Australia in the Ashes series.
That was the biggest story of the week.
That was the biggest story this week. Oh, the Aussies are upset. I mean, fair play. It's going to be an amazing Ashes series. Yep. It already is an amazing Ashes series. But, Brian, I don't know how much you like cricket, but Scotland were unfortunately bundled out of the qualifying for the Men's Cricket World Cup last week.
Oh, that's unfortunate.
Next week, though, it's the European qualifiers for next year's T20 World Cup.
Who is?
Scotland are playing in that. Yeah, Scotland, I think they have, well, like, done. Germany coming up and Denmark, perhaps.
Oh, the big guns.
Yeah. Denmark, they love their cricket.
Now, look, we've seen Michael Sheen on TV giving a rousing speech to the Welsh footballers.
Right.
Would you mind... We've prepared a speech for you. Would you
what?
Mind coming up to... coming up to the lectern...
This was not part of the deal. You're just here to humiliate me, and I don't really like it.
We've written this... Would you mind preparing a speech for the Scottish T20 cricketers?
When you pad up, well, you know you're going to be. You're going to be the team who's proudly white and blue. And when you bowl fast, yeah, you know you're going to be. You're going to be the team who simply cannot lose. And if you swing well, you know you're going to be. You're going to be the team on 600 for two. And if you're losing and the batsman isn't watching, just think, what would those cheating Aussies do? 'Cause you will score 500 runs. And you will score 500 more. Just to be the team who scores 1,000 runs and hears the Scottish roar. Come on, Scotland!
Beautiful. Beautiful. We'll have more last league.
I might get extra for that.
We'll have more last league for you after the break as we give Rosie a grilling about her new documentary. Plus, we want to know what other excuses will Boris Johnson give for not handing over his phone. Tweet us at the last league. Use the hashtag BorisBS or just reply to us on Threads. See you in a little bit. Last leg. We're joined by Rosie Jones, Bubba Tunde Aleshe and Brian Cox. A lot of people, some people tweeting not sure whether the Just Stop Oil protest was genuine. In fact, I'm not even sure our audience is sure. That was genuinely not part of the show.
I wouldn't have looked as pathetic if it was.
I'll tell you what, I would have jumped in front of anything for you.
Yeah. You know, you kind of kid yourself that maybe your partner or your friends or even your agent watches the show.
Yep.
I got my phone, I was like, bloody hell, I bet a lot of people have texted me about this. I haven't had one.
All right, let's move on.
That's obvious. Because we're on.
Rowan Crump said, is it OK that friend of the show Rosie Jones has used an ableist slur in the title of her new documentary? Now, Rosie's documentary airs on Channel 4 on Thursday the 20th of July at 10 p.m. In it, she tackles online abuse of disabled people. Here's a clip of Rosie being shown some of the things that have been said about her online.
Great
going on the abuse.
And we can have a look at some of it here. It's hate speech, you know. It's
yeah.
like really
yeah.
unpleasant and borderline getting into hate speech where it's illegal territory.
Yeah. Joel is showing me over 400 messages they've blocked. It's amazing how 3 words I just reduced me down to my disability.
It's so powerful, that documentary. It's so powerful. Why did you choose to use that word in the title?
Yeah, and I talked about it a lot this week, and I know that the R word in particular is very upsetting for a lot of people. And I personally hate that word. It has been used as a weapon towards me for 33 years. And unfortunately, it is still a word that is used casually in pubs, in schools, in the street and online. And sometimes, in order to make change, I think you need to tackle the subject head on. You need to grab hold of that weapon and put it towards the people and say, it is not okay, it is never okay to use language like this as a form of abuse or casually without thinking. So, unfortunately, not every disabled person will agree with me, but this is my experience and in my way to start the conversation on ableism and online abuse. And it's not been easy at all. This has been such a difficult year making it, but it is the proudest thing I've ever done.
I'm proud of you.
Thank you.
During Rosie speaking, there was a Just Stop Oil person who was putting stuff back in their bag. This isn't the time!
And look, while we're talking TV shows, we've also got to say congratulations, Brian. 27 Emmy nominations for Succession and one for you. Congratulations.
I just want to say to Rosie, what incredible courage!
Yeah.
Really, you're an example to everybody, and it's a pleasure to be here with you.
Thanks. Agreed. I know all of us are fans of Succession. I have one very fan question. What do you do to prepare to get into the role? Because, like, the role of Logan is completely different to you. What do you do to get into the right headspace?
The most important thing is to learn your lines and don't bump into the furniture. That's what's known as the actor despairs. The actor prepares.
And look, you know, Logan is known for having a catchphrase, which is fuck off.
Yeah.
Is that annoying, having that as your catchphrase?
Yeah. No, it's just one of those unfortunate things. I mean, do you want a story?
Yeah, go on.
I'm in L.A., the land of the lost, and I'm there, and it's the Golden Globes, and I'm invited to this evening, which is... well, it's an afternoon, actually, with Ronan Farrow, who's doing his Me Too book, and there are all these amazingly intense Hollywood women with their... Anyway, they're all there. And they're taking it all in, and they're getting really intense, and it's getting really intense, and he's, you know, he's doing really well. I mean, it's good stuff, and there's a huge round of applause. I arrive late, so I'm standing at the back, sort of like this, watching it all, and suddenly all these women turn around and see me, and they go, oh, and they get out their device and say, can you tell us to fuck off? And I go, is this really appropriate at a meeting? If you ask a white dinosaur to tell you to fuck off, then fuck off.
Carmela said, is it okay to hope for a fuck off buzzer from Brian Cox? So we've got one ready. If you would like to, I'm going to leave a gap. If you can say fuck off, it takes about a minute and we can officially have a buzzer.
What do I have to do? Come over there?
No, just say it where
oh,
you
I
are.
Say here.
Yep.
Okay. Fuck off.
Lovely. We'll have that on the button in a minute. Moving on, US President Joe Biden was in the UK this week and met King Charles. We can only assume they talked about what they have in common, starting a new job in your 70s and having a son you're concerned about. After spending some time with a rich man who inherited great power but was never elected, he met with Rishi Sunak.
How is Rishi the same size as him in that photo?
And look, we noticed this week there's been a new addition to the steps of Air Force One with a reminder to Joe Biden on how to climb the stairs.
Yeah.
There's one a few steps down that just says check for dog shit on your shoes.
Thoughts on Joe Biden?
Well, I like Joe Biden, except he is decrepit. No, sorry, I didn't mean that. He is decrepit. No, I mean, he's a good man. He's a really good man. He's a good politician. But he's got this thing about the fact he jogged all his life.
Yeah.
And when you jog, listen, if you're under 55, stop fucking jogging. Because it does your knees in. It really does your knees in. So he's like, you know, look at me.
Mm-hmm.
Exactly.
Right. Come on.
You know, never jogged in my fucking life. Joe Biden.
Baba Tunde, what do you think of him?
Right, he needs to sleep. He needs to go home and sleep. He's like, he's the oldest man on earth.
And look, as Russia's war in Ukraine hit 500 days, we're doing a thing on the show where we're seeing if Vladimir Putin can last longer than a cabbage. It's not looking great, I'm going to be honest. And it's not smelling great either. But so far, I don't know who's going to last the longest. A few weeks ago, we overdubbed Vladimir Putin's speech with the voice of comedian Joe Pasquale to make him seem less powerful. Well, after watching this...
What a show.
After watching this slightly dull video the White House made of Joe Biden's visit this week, we kind of need to do the opposite. Check out the video first.
Good to be back. Couldn't be meeting with a closer friend and a greater ally. Our relationship is rock solid.
Like, great, but meh. It could have been more. Yeah. So we thought we'd spice it up a little, and what we've done, we've enlisted the help of the UK's best movie trailer voiceover guy, a guy by the name of Red Pepper. Now, you might not have seen Red before, but you've definitely heard him. What we're going to do right now is we're going to play that video again. Red's going to do the voiceover and give it a little bit of welly. Roll tape.
In a world of turmoil, one man can bring us all together. He came here to kick butt and drink tea, and he's left his mug at home. Joe Biden is President Badass. He'll make you laugh. He'll sign some paper. He'll take a look around London, and he'll watch some men in bobbly hats play some funny music, starring King Charles as the new guy. If you only see one president this summer, make it Joe. President Badass. The special relationship just got specialer. Come to a palace near you.
Thank you, Red. That was amazing. We'll have more Last Leg for you after the break as we say why I to AI. Plus, we want to know what excuses should Boris Johnson give for not handing over his phone. Reply to us on Threads or tweet us at the Last Leg. Use the hashtag BorisBS. See you very soon. Last Leg. We're joined by Rosa Jones, Babatunde Eleshe and Brian Cox. Fiona Main says, is it okay that technology is on its way to make a future where human beings are irrelevant and some people seem okay with it? Hashtag save ticket officers, hashtag AI, hashtag actor strike. Now, the letters A and I are on everyone's lips this week. Ticket officers, Wimbledon line judges, even Hollywood actors are in danger of being replaced. In America, writers and actors are on strike for a number of reasons at the moment, one of which, though, is the use of AI technology. For example, it's been proposed that background actors in a scene could be scanned and paid for a day's work. The film company would then own their image forever and be allowed to use it in any movie. Brian, how do you feel about that?
Horrible. Terrible. But, you know, the thing about AI is it's artificial intelligence. And most of the human race is artificially intelligent. So I don't think it's amiss. I think it's completely understandable, really.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's interesting. Do you think it's possible they'll make AI movies for people?
Oh, they're going to do it. They're going to try. Yeah. They can't do it because they can't get the nuance. The one thing that AI can't do is nuance.
Yeah.
And nuance is the most important. It's not what people say. It's how they look. You know, in movies, you can give something away just in a two-second look.
Yeah.
You don't have to say it. And AI can't deal with that.
Yeah. Rosie,
so we're going to go back to silent movies.
Rosie?
Obviously, I made it about me.
Mm.
So I got worried that you will get higher AI comedians. So what I did is I put my last show, the script, into ChatGPT.
Mm.
And I said, write my next show. And to be fair, the first few jokes were like decent jokes, and then it went so sexual. And it just started talking about tits the whole time. So, yeah, I can be replaced. And that joke was written by AI.
We're in the middle of it. We're in it. Babatunde?
No, I stand with the actors, man. I'm against what AI is trying to do. You know?
Yeah, man. Well, we put AI to the task this week. We asked an AI chatbot to write a scene from Succession.
Oh, wow!
And we're going to act it out for you at the end of the show. But what we also did this week was we asked an AI chatbot to write some weird facts about Josh. And
what?
I'm going to be honest. We said, come up, not write some, come up with. Can you tell us some weird facts about, some odd facts about Josh Whittaker?
About me, thank you very much.
So this is what it actually thought was an odd fact about Josh Whittaker.
standing at 6 feet 4 inches. I mean, I don't need to go any further there. So what
they
we thought
even get that, they're shit at their job.
So what we thought we'd do tonight is we're gonna play a little game called Would AI Lie to You? So Brian, Rosie and Babatunde are gonna be given one fact about Josh, one about Alex, one about me. One of those facts is true, the other two have been AI generated. So between you, try and work out which is the truth and which is the two AI lies. The fact about me, Adam once got into an onstage scuffle with the Swedish chef from The Muppet Show after attempting to steal one of the chef's wooden ladles. They later made up and remain friends to this day. Alex, in 2013, Alex took part in a charity event where he attempted to break the world record for the most high fives in an hour. He managed to achieve an impressive number of high fives, spreading joy and raising awareness for charity in the process. Josh, as a child, Josh's claim to fame was accidentally bumping into the late Princess Diana during a family trip to Alton Towers. He has humorously recounted the incident, highlighting his lack of awareness of the princess's identity at the time. So, which one of those is true?
Oh, God, why are you looking at me?
I'm trying to work it out, bro.
My scuffle, right. My scuffle with the Muppets, Alex's high five world record, or Josh bumping into Princess Diana?
I feel like, as a fellow disabled person, I need to clarify, Alex, high five.
I put them together.
Okay.
We like to call in the business. It's
which one?
Two's up.
Which one do you think is true?
Which one are we going to go for?
What's not true?
Which one is true? The Muppets, the high fives, or Princess Diana?
I think Josh is true.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Josh.
Josh's is a lie. It was an AI lie.
Then it's you.
Yes. Mine was true. I did get into an onstage scuffle with the Swedish chef and we are friends to this day. And
said
Alex
something about his mouth.
And Alex's high five event was made up by the AI. You didn't win, so as a consolation prize, you get my mole.
G'day.
There you go. We'll have more Last Link for you after the break as Josh wraps up the last 7 days, and we are going to act out that scene from Succession that was written by AI. We'll see you in a little bit. Welcome back to Last Leg. We are joined by Rosie Jones, Babatunde Aleshe and Brian Cox. We are all dressed for a scene from Succession that has been written by AI. We're going to do it at the end of the show. Alex has gone off to get into character because he's method. Before we do it, though, Josh has been remembering the code of the last 7 days. What have you got?
Just so you know, I have received one text seeing if I was all right from my bank manager. right. Before we do this clip, I need to just say, I say this sometimes, the cat was fine.
Oh, I love any clip that starts with that sentence.
Okay, would you like to see a great clip of an eager cat getting into the sea?
Yes.
Careful, please. Really careful. Not yet. Roger.
It's okay. Come back over here.
One more. Would you like to see an ambitious dance on a kitchen worktop?
Yes.
Yes.
All right, very quickly, we ask you what excuses Boris Johnson should give for not handing over his phone. Martin said he lost it at a lockdown party. Alice said he left it at Peppa Pig World. Brianna said he left it in his other trousers and he can't remember whose house they're in. We are about to end the show with a scene from Succession as written by AI, but before we do, would you please thank our guests, Rosie Jones, Babatunde Aleshe, and Brian Cox, and my co-host Josh Whittaker, and Alex Brooker. We'll be back next week with comedians Tim Minchin and Judy Love, but right now we want to see whether AI scriptwriters are going to put us all out of work. During the week, we asked an AI chatbot to write a scene from Succession, and we're going to act it out now. This is genuine. All we entered in were the names of the characters and one bit of information from tonight's show, and then the machine did the rest. I'm going to be honest ahead of time, it's a bit shit. And we actually had to write the final line ourselves to make it work. But here it is.
Logan Roy, the imposing and calculating patriarch, sits at the head of the table. Surrounding him are his children. Kendall, the ambitious but troubled heir. Shiv, the sharp and assertive daughter. Roman, the cunning and unpredictable middle child. Tom, Shiv's well-meaning but naive husband.
All right, you bunch of jackals. We're here to discuss the future of this company.
He's really good.
Dad, I've been analyzing our digital strategy. I think we should focus, you know, on expanding our streaming platform.
Oh, Kendall, how original. Streaming. Can you come up with anything else?
Hey, I believe in the potential of digital media. It's the future, Shiv.
Oh, come on, Ken.
That was quite good, that, wasn't it?
Yeah, thank you.
The future. You sound like a damn sci-fi movie.
Well, actually, there have been some interesting developments in the tech industry lately.
What the bloody hell is going on now?
Greetings, humans of Waystar Royco. I am Zorblax, emissary from the... I'm so sorry about this, Brian. I am Zorblax, emissary from the Galactic Trade Federation. I possess knowledge beyond your comprehension. My technology can revolutionise your business, expand your reach across the cosmos. Also, mate, have you seen this? My little finger does it.
Oh, fuck off.
Thanks for watching The Last Leg. My name's Adam Hills. We'll see you next week for the next leg. Good night!